probably going to take probably about 3 hours or something. The last few levels I'm not great at. I am in the process currently of signing up for a speedrun competition with Shovel Knight. So I have a run here that it shows no time. It's because I'm not trusting the in-game timer, and I'm just working on level 1 over and over, trying to get the optimal route down. So that's what that is. This is just a run I'm doing just on the side. You know, it's been a little over 2 hours. It's nothing I'm taking seriously. Apparently, I don't have the feat for having beaten this game, which I think is funny, because I've beaten this game like probably 30 times. It's tied for my favorite game of all time ever, and it is my favorite soundtrack of all time, like video game soundtrack. I think it's fucking amazing. But yeah, I don't have the achievement, apparently, for beating Shovel Knight, the base game. I have the achievements for beating both of the DLC add-ons. So, like, why the hell would I have the achievements for the other ones if I didn't beat the main game first? How would I have, like, 45 hours in this game if I didn't beat the game first? So we're gonna go ahead and just replay Shovel Knight, just for fun. Not gonna do any speedrun strats, not gonna put in any cheats. Just gonna kind of do it for fun, you know? It's a great game, and I adore it. So, since we are playing in the shit mode anyways, we are gonna turn on... I don't know if body swap mode affects... I wouldn't assume body swap mode affects if you get achievements or not. I don't think so. I think it's just a fun way to replay it, from my understanding. So we're gonna go ahead and just kind of play it. Hopefully you guys enjoy. Also, I will turn down the audio a bit. Makes me sad, because the audio in this game is fucking awesome. But we are going to just run through it again, just because it's a good time. And again, I'm not going to do the speedrun route, even though I could, and I could be done with this level in under a minute, is what I've gotten it down to. I've gotten it down to where I can beat this level in about 53 seconds. So, I mean, I could do that, but we'll save that for the speedrun contest, of course. Don't want to give away my secrets early, but yeah, we're going to go ahead and just kind of have a casual run through it, because this game's fucking awesome. And the guy who made the soundtrack actually is the Bard, as you may have guessed. Jake Kaufman, I believe is his name. Jake, I know his last name starts with a K. Jake, I'm like, I can't believe I forgot his name. I was looking at it literally earlier today, listening to the soundtrack just for fun. And you know, normally for speedrunning I would just go over this guy, but you know, it'll be fun to fuck with him. So we're gonna go ahead and fight his ass. Just cause it's a fun run. What the fuck? Half the time he hits you, half the time he doesn't. There's a way to time it so he can't hit you, if you don't have to kill him or anything. I don't remember what it is. That's part of why I'm working on this level over and over and over. Just for that exact reason. Because it's little shit like that, that in the long run is going to cost me a lot of time. Especially for like a speedrun contest. And it's not 100%, it's an any percent, just get to the end of the game sort of deal. Which I'm pretty damn excited for. It gives me an excuse to play this game more frequently, and I guess with a new mindset of not, oh my god, we're playing Shovel Knight again, but more of like, sweet, I gotta try and beat my time and be competitive with it, because it's a fucking great game, and I love it. I'm excited to get to be a little bit competitive with one of my favorite games. I get to listen to this damn soundtrack over and over, which is always a plus. But my god, I still have that plugged ear though, which isn't excellent. Normally, again, I wouldn't be breaking all the things. But even in a standard run for me, I normally don't break all the fucking things. I just kind of go for it. But you know, it'll be nice to have that extra little bit of gold. It'll be a fun time. Sorry I'm not saying super a lot, because I'm part of me sitting here, like, you know, running through. That's the one problem with speedrunning a game I've found personally, is, like, even, you know, the fact that I am, in theory, going to be speedrunning it in a few months. I did sign up. The application is pending approval, which means, from what I understand, from what I read on my website and shit, it's like, they've seen it, and because it's pending approval, I think I'm in, but that I had an email saying that they're just waiting to see if they have any more openings, like how many openings they have for Shovel Knight in particular, and then they will send me an email and let me know if I made it. Which I think would be pretty cool. I think speedrunning a game would be fun. I actually don't know where all the secrets in this game are. I used to when I, like, there was a phase where I got super into this game. I would just play it every day, multiple times. Just because it was fun. And I did the same thing with Portal. I've done the same thing with Dark Souls 3. It's just kind of a thing that happens when I get really into a game. I'll just play it way too much to the point where it isn't fun. If you do this just right, the dragon will back up. Okay. Come on, Drago. What's he gonna fucking do? He's gonna drop the apple. Okay. Sometimes you can get him to back up onto that ledge. So that when he dies, you can safely collect all the treasure. But such is not the case today, so I guess we don't have to deal with that. We don't even have to concern ourselves with that bullshit. And it is very much as an RNG thing. I mean, there is a way, like the way that I do it, I've been practicing this for the speedrun. It's gotten me there every time, but I mean, that's because you come at him so fast. You're more bouncing over him than actually fighting him. But yeah, it turns out, like, I had beaten this game, but every time I had done it, it had been in, like, offline mode. So, every time I beat this game, it didn't count. Because every time I beat it, I was beating it, like, at friends' houses and stuff, because they didn't believe that I played this game a shit ton. And apparently, I never took the time to beat it at home with the internet functioning. At least that's my theory. I don't see any other reason why I could have beaten this game so many times and not beaten it. I just think that's silly. I don't know, maybe it's just me being a goof. Come on, Nuba. I love this. If you can get him in the corner just right, you can actually bounce on him near eternally. And you can get him in a loop where he'll continually try to do that jump attack into your shovel, and it's fucking amazing. You can generally get 3 hits on him. There's also the speedrun tactic of literally just get him in the corner and just jump hit him. I'm not good at that, which is why I didn't even try. But yeah, I'm very excited to do list speedrunning. And the reason that I have a mod, or a cheat, on my speedrun, by the way, is they assign you colors. And so based on the information I got back in the email, they were saying, like, my place in the speedrun is this. So based upon that, I looked at all the cheat codes, and if they're going in alphabetical order, then this would be the color I would be assigned alphabetically. So that's why I have a cheat on, is because if I'm going to be speedrunning with a certain color on, I kind of want to get used to seeing Shovel Knight in that color, if that makes any fucking sense. Probably doesn't, but in my head it makes sense. Like, if I'm going to have to look at him in a certain way for this long, then I kind of want to get used to seeing that. I generally go for food first. I generally do food. I don't really get magic because I get, I like to wear the purple armor, which, the purple armor actually gets you a shit ton of magic. So, and I'm only gonna buy one of these so that I can also buy the fishing pole. And that way I still have, you know what, I will buy the second tropical chalice now. Sometimes I don't buy it immediately, other times I do. Just kind of depends on my mood. And today, that mood is, fuck this, we're gonna go ahead and just We're just gonna go ahead and grab it. Also, I do have a frog in my throat. I did just wake up, and I have been kind of fighting a cold, so sorry. Oh, fuck. Sorry about that. Also, fun fact, this is the first, this is the first level in the game, and if you go left, a lot of people don't know this. I don't blame them. I didn't know this for the longest time. But you can come back here, and there's the Yacht Club Games logo. And there's also a fishing spot. So extra money on King Knight stage, just for, you know, giving the devs some screen time. Well, I've messed up perfect timing for, yeah, there's a way you can run through the whole thing without having to stop. There's a way to time that. I fucked it up by doing a second bounce on accident. And the reason I'm not getting all these dirt piles is because I'm getting extra gold from, like, the... I'm gonna get extra gold from the minigame. There's the minigame in the main town that I'm decent enough at. That I generally... I make money off of it every time I play. So it's like... I don't really... Fucking... Come on. Just damage goes through it, I guess. Apparently shit at this game. Come on. I hate sometimes the propeller counts. I think they changed it so the propeller always counts, but I know it used to be like, oh, you stand in the propeller and it wouldn't hurt you. Since I've been playing this game, since it came out, I do remember that, and I get confused oftentimes. And part of that's just because I'm shit at games in general, so... I love they try and make this big deal out of that guy. Like, he gets his own... Oh, fuck. He gets his own room and stuff. But I have never actually had a problem with him, like, ever in my life. Fucking, okay. I guess the speedrun run through it isn't happening today. That's okay. Still works here, though. And I am gonna go get the flare wand because, in my opinion, it is one of the more useful items in the game. Like, this is a lot of times where being able to shoot straight in front of you is actually incredibly useful. Plus, you can make, like, I think it's like 200 bucks, I think, on the way out of here. So, not like a huge deal. Not out of here, but like out of the... I don't know what the fuck I'm saying. I've got to be real with you. I'm going to pause real quick. Take a drink. Sorry, I'm opening a 2-liter. Okay. Okay, let's continue. Sorry about that. I love how many times I have been hit on the way out of that. Because I didn't understand the timing on the pod. But as you can see, once I killed these boys. And it's not super important that you kill them. I just like to do it. Because, fuck it, I don't know. But yeah, we have a projectile as well now. I am actually going to grab that carrot before we leave. Generally a carrot. I mean, I think the fruit that's in it is, oh fuck, yeah, it's obviously random, because sometimes there's food in it, other times there's a bomb. I do think it's fun that they randomize it a little bit. Makes it a little more interesting. I remember when I found this secret the first time, it fucking blew my mind. Because there's not like a spot on that wall, you just have to be intuitive enough to think, hey, what the fuck happened if I hit this wall again? Because like, it's pretty cool. It's also an achievement that I will probably get next run. It is a no checkpoint run. I do plan on doing that. It does sound like a hell of a lot of fun. Also, a cool thing you can do is you can just fucking try and fuck it up. You can just bounce on his head and get around him. You don't actually have to fight the griffin. Or you can come up from behind him and just kind of be a bitch about it. I mean, the only way to actually hit him is to hit him in the face. So like, you have to come around here anyways to do it. I just figured I would show you that that is a thing you can do. The speedrun strat used to be the damage boost through that, like I did. But there's actually a way to jump through him without taking damage. I just didn't do it because it fucking sucked. Oops. This part actually is harder than you think. Like, it's a lot of one-hit enemies. But because of the way that they're positioned, it is very possible to die there. So, that's a fun little facto. Oops, fucking shit. I was hoping to get behind it, but whatever. That way this exact shit doesn't happen. It's stressful getting in between a bunch of wizards. I also remember when I started this game when I didn't realize how easy it is to get money if you actually genuinely want it. Because, like, one thing that a lot of people don't realize is you can replay a level and beat it and get more gold out of it. So I think it's funny that people don't always get all the armor and all that, because, like, really, it only takes an extra couple minutes. You know, you can go through like this level and you can get, I think it's about 4 grand out of it, if you get everything. And it's like, so really, I don't see an excuse to not have all the armor and all the shovel upgrades. I know there was an achievement for that, and I felt silly for not getting it, because I realized this exact thing, that you can just kind of replay a level and get all your shit back. And so why wouldn't I get it, you know? A pretty damn simple thing. Pretty simple thing to go ahead and get that extra gold if you really genuinely want it. I don't know why I literally every time end up bouncing in that pattern and then abandoning him on those two blocks. I just think it's funny, I guess. I don't know. But every single time I play this level, that's the exact position I leave him in. And I don't know why it started, I don't know how it started, that was almost really bad. Also, fun thing, I think, is watching 100% speedruns. Because, like, the 100% speedruns, I think, are, like, a little over 2 hours. But you think about it, and this game, the first time through, takes most people... I know my first time through, it took me about 6 hours. Partially because I'm shit at games. I forgot I didn't fill up my teleport ballast. But that's what those guys are for. They'll fill it up with some random bullshit that you really didn't want. What the fuck? Okay. It was because I hung out too long on that other screen. That was just my bad. I didn't get that back. The screen was up for too long because these count as the same screen since it's like one continuous deal. So see, normally that rat is much, much lower. So generally you can just keep jumping, and I didn't even think about it, so fucked it up like a damn fool. Most of the time on single player, one of these is a chicken, one of them is a bomb, so you just kind of have to hit one and get lucky with it, I guess. And again, I'm not doing like a speedrun. Sorry, my voice is just fucking awful today. I'm not trying to do any sort of speed run. I'm just kind of playing it for fun, just because apparently I haven't beaten it according to Steam. which is bullshit, and I have. Anyone who knows me knows I've beaten this game like a bunch. It's one of, it is tied for my favorite game of all time, Dark Souls. Because I absolutely adore, like, Mega Man-style games, but I'm shitting Mega Man, and I don't know, I just think the aesthetic is funny, and, like, the characters are very well done, like, they're funny as hell. I don't know when the King of the Cards DLC is coming out, but I know that's supposed to be coming out sometime, I believe, early 2018, so I'm pretty fucking excited for that, because that's the only one I haven't beaten at this point. Except apparently the main game. I apparently didn't beat that. Which I think is funny because I know I have, but whatever. That's why we're doing this, and that's why we're doing it on a stream. That way, not only... That way, if Steam doesn't give me the achievement, I can be like, yo, fam. Like, that's bullshit. Also, a fun thing you can do with the trouble. We do have to watch his entire dance the whole way through. But what you can do is if you have a chalice already, you can literally drink it right in front of him and then ask for his aid and ask him to fill up your chalices. I like the health one myself. The invincibility one, I can see where it would be useful. I just personally, like, I don't know. I don't find myself in positions where I need to be able to damage boost through stuff more than a full health would help me. Also on that other run that I'm doing, just kind of on the side for fun, literally two steps in front of Plague Knight's boss door, I forgot that there was chicken in the floor, so I used my chalice, and then in the boss fight, his boss fight's a little random, I thought it was funny that I kept dying. I was like, you know what would have been great if I had that damn chalice? I didn't want to replay the whole thing. Also, fun fact, the Trouble actually has different dances in all of the DLCs. The way you get to him in Plague Knight and Plague Knight's, what is it? I forget the name of his thing. I don't really enjoy his campaign that much. Spectre Knights is my favorite, actually. I mean, Shovel Knights is my favorite, but Spectre Knight of the DLC, I just enjoy the playstyle a lot. I didn't really enjoy Plague Knight as a playable character. He was funny, like, as a character he's funny, but I don't think playing him is fun, if that makes sense. Like, I don't know, it wasn't for me, I guess. The entire point of the whole fucking thing. They just hold it, oh, I don't fucking know, da-da-da-da. No, the whole point of it is it's not for me, and I, like, expect him, what the fuck, that's stupid. That's stupid. Fucking no. These Dragos. Come on, Drago. I mean, there's no time limit here. There's no anything like that. So we're gonna go ahead and just kind of fucking... kind of get all the treasure. Also, I'm gonna get rid of these music things. Just because you make actually a shit ton of money if you do that. I am gonna go ahead and buy a second health, because right now I'm not in a position where I'm needing, magic all that much. Generally, I only upgrade magic once, and then I get the magic armor. So it'll be my armor will, or my magic will be 40, and then I'll get the armor and it boosts it up to 90. So having a lot of health. Especially if you're going to get the purple armor, because you take double damage, so instead of half a heart every hit, you take a full heart. Having a shit ton of health is incredibly useful. And of course, I don't do that for speed run. I do the fucking four heart, whatever. I hate these frogs. They're actually the one thing in the game that is 100% random. Because they have, like, I think there's like four variants of jump height and jump distance, and just depending upon how they fucking feel, they can just get in your way or completely avoid you, and it's kind of annoying, if I'm being quite honest. As far as speedrunning goes, I think they're a fun enemy. Like, it's cool to have kind of an RNG enemy like that. I always think that's a neat touch. But I also play a lot of roguelike, so RNG shit is kind of a thing that I enjoy. But no, I think they make a fun enemy. I think it's a good touch to have at least a single enemy in this game that's fuck. Also, I don't know why people don't always get all, like I was saying, the shovel upgrades. I can get not getting all the armor. I'm gonna get all of the armor this run just because it's fun, whatever. But, so I don't know why people struggle with this man. Like, he literally almost kills himself. See, he almost kills himself for you. And it's just funny to me that people are like, oh my god, he's hard, dude. I'm like, no, he's not. Anyways, I need to stop talking about, like, oh, I'm better than you with Shovel Knight. It's not the point of that. It's not. It's just things I find funny as someone who plays it quite a lot. And, I don't know, follows, like, competitive scene and stuff for Shovel Knight. Also, you don't actually have to hit those frogs. So, in theory, you can actually, you can just not have them jump at you. Which is generally what I fucking do, but... I also always clear this out because when you make the shortcut, if you don't, they will, they'll still be there, and they get in your way a lot of the times. They kind of block your way out, and it's frustrating. Also, this chest is kind of in the worst spot, and I love it because of that, because it's like, do you want to risk the chest, or do you want to try and get the, you want to try and get the treasure? And I always go for the treasure, because obviously it's fucking treasure, you know? Treasure's the fucking best. Also, oh my god. Also, one thing I'm excited to do is every single time I've tried to orchestrate doing a co-op of this game, like beating the entire campaign, and I almost like can't tag it, because that's how I say it for fun, when it's just me. Because I think it's silly. But every single time I've tried to have someone play this game co-op with me, it's always fallen apart. And when my brother comes over for Christmas, we are actually going to try to beat this entire fucking game, and that would be cool, because it's a great game. And the co-op mode, it's not as cool as on Nintendo, gotta be real, on the Switch and shit. Nintendo paid to have that mode specifically only on Nintendo consoles, because they had said, like, oh, well, we can give you, like, how about we add, what were they gonna add? Fuck, they were gonna add, I think, Tingle as, like, a boss fight. Like, a wandering random boss. What the fuck? I'm apparently just shit at this game. But yeah, they were gonna add Tingle as a boss, and Nintendo was like, nah, fam. You've added characters for... You've added, like, fights for every other company. We want a fucking game mode. So how about you make that happen? And, like... Good move, Nintendo, because the amiibo shit is fucking awesome. Like, I'm going to buy it on Switch purely for the amiibo co-op. And I'm gonna buy a Shovel Knight amiibo, but that's also because I fucking adore Shovel Knight. And for me, as a huge Shovel Knight fan, that's completely worth it. But I understand to a lot of people that seems really stupid to waste your money, but this is, you know, one of my favorite games. So for me, I think it's awesome. Also, how am I taking so much damage? I will buy the Phase Locket because it makes one of the, it's one of the challenges, oh my god. It's one of the challenges 10,000% easier. What the hell, okay. That's stupid. I was gonna say there's literally chicken, like, the next room over. Which is why I wasn't hyper concerned with the fact that I was dying. Go through the dark part again. But yeah, Spectre Knight is my favorite of the other knights. I mean, I guess you could say, oh, well, his character is very bland. If you say that, you haven't played his DLC. His DLC is fucking awesome. I also love you can do this if you time it right. You can just have them kill themselves on the water, and you can just casually run away and not have to deal with them. But yeah, I hate... That's the one thing about Spectre Knight that I hate, is that his stage has all of this darkness bullshit. Like, it's a cool mechanic, don't get me wrong, but it's also kind of frustrating to play through. Because, like, you know, unless you are, like, pixel-perfect on your placement and shit, you're gonna just fucking it up. and it's just kind of like, oh, one more thing that's gonna take a long time, you know? It's not even, like, specifically anyone's fucking fault either, it's just a thing. Okay, while I actually have health and the phase locket, I am actually gonna go the other way. You know, that was a lot of magic for that, but you also have to consider how worth it is to, you know, have your money back. So, I would say that was a completely worthwhile trade-off, personally. It's also really nice, I gotta be honest, playing this game in a non-speedrun format. It's nice to just kind of be able to chill and take my time and gather things. I also haven't gathered every note in the game. Like every music sheet and stuff like that. There's a lot of stuff in this game that I actually haven't done. But it's kind of because, like, I started playing Shovel Knight a bunch, and I kept trying to play it co-op. So I kept bringing it to people's houses and playing it with other people, not actually, you know, trying to beat it myself. Because that's one thing I love about these games, is, like, the co-op. I think the co-op is really well implemented, considering it's a game that was not originally designed to have co-op in it. I think it was very well implemented, and I like it a lot. So, that's, I guess, part of my excuse for myself as to why I didn't beat it. As to why I've never beaten it myself, even though I should have, because it's a fucking wonderful game. But yeah, here comes the darkness. Fucking these frogs. Swear to God. But yeah, every time I tried to play it, it was always trying to be co-op with somebody. And it's like, there came a point where I was just like, oh, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna play this game for me, for fun. It's gonna be fucking awesome. But as you can see, when I'm actually just kind of going for it, I think I know this game relatively well. Like, I feel like since, you know, it is tied for my favorite game, it's definitely my favorite platformer, easily. So I guess I can still call it my favorite. Because I think it's platformer. I know I went through a phase for a while, every fucking day I would be like, oh, well this game that I'm playing currently is my new favorite of all time. And it's like, I need to just realize that I like a lot of fucking games for a lot of fucking reasons. And it's a thing I get to deal with, is like, loving a lot of games. It's not a big deal. Like, you know, people go through phases, people, you know, deal with shit like that all the time, such as me. But it was kind of frustrating on my end. Because, like, everyone's like, oh, what's your favorite game? And they're like, I genuinely don't even fucking know. Because you change what your favorite game is every damn day. And it's like, yeah, that was really dumb of me. And I'm like, oh, damn it. First damage, he's almost dead though, so don't feel bad about it. He's actually quite easy if you just kind of focus. I remember when I first played this game, I thought he was literally the devil. I feel like that, honestly, with the last three bosses, with, like, Propeller Knight, Polar Knight, and Tinker Knight. Tinker Knight being my personal favorite of the three, like, as far as to fight first. My favorite song in this game, though, is from Propeller Knight. Like, I think he's cool. I also think he's bullshit to fight. I mean, generally you have really good armor and all the upgrades, and, like, you're strong enough to deal with him, but it's, like, it's just enough that it bothers me. Also, Treasure Knight, from the section before, every fucking time I do this stage, I always lose, like, a shit ton of gold. And it infuriates me, because I'm better than this. Am I gonna die on the bonus thing? Part of me was like, oh, I gotta get treasure. Because see, if you survive it, which generally you will, unless you're really bad at games, as long as you survive that, you get actually a health upgrade because you beat a zone. So it's like, But yeah, Treasure Knight, I kind of hate. He's generally the one I do first, because if I don't spend money beforehand, actually, I'm gonna do the, before I do this, I'm actually gonna go ahead and do the Forest of Phasing, before, just so I have more money to buy health upgrades. Because I might, I was thinking about it, I don't think I'm actually going to buy all of the armor in this run. Because as nice as it sounds to have all the armor, really the only one I'm going to use would be either the red one, which lets you drop half the amount of gold every time you die, or the gold one, because it's just flips and shit, and who doesn't want to do flips and shit? Flips and shit are the best. This part's always sketchy as fuck. Because it makes you realize how short the timer is on this, how short the timer is on the phase logget. Because you're like, oh, that's not that far, I can make that. And then you actually can't. I have died there so many times. It's not actually funny anymore how many times I've passed away there. Also, what the fuck? I turned on the thing that's supposed to let my, supposed to make sure my screen doesn't turn off. So that if anyone ever decides to show up and hang out with me, probably won't happen, let's face it. But if anyone were to do that, oh, I didn't activate it, I'm a fucking idiot. Yeah, but if anyone were to do that, I could actually, you know, see that they're talking and shit like that. I do need to, really quick, there's a message that I got. Actually, that's really important that I deal with. Okay, that's all done. Okay, back to the chat. Okay, so now that that's done, there's also this, which is just more money. I always like the money stages. It's nice to be able to afford upgrades. I'm only going to actually upgrade my health 2 more times, because that's all you actually need. I've found, for me personally anyways, I know some people might say, oh, well, if you're not going to be buying upgrades until fucking the next zone, why the fuck wouldn't you go ahead and, like, I don't fucking know what I'm trying to say, why wouldn't you go ahead and just upgrade the shit out of your health so you have, like, near infinite health? And I get why you would say that, but you also have to understand that, like, no, there are other things I need to save money for. So, like, because I want to be able to get at least the mighty fucking, the treasure shovel? I don't remember what the fuck it's called. The upgrade for your shovel that lets you dig those mounds in one hit. I want to get that immediately. Also cool thing, if you want more money, is if you go downstairs, a lot of people don't know this, but there's a secret music sheet for Killing Spectre Knight. So that's pretty cool. I don't have a second one of these. I am going to upgrade my magic. I'm only going to do it the one time. And then, 6 grand. I mean, I'm probably going to lose that much when I do, I'm probably going to lose that much when I do Spectre Knight, to be real. But yeah, you talk to this lady and she does her little dance. And that's another 500 gold for me. There's also one, I've already gotten it, but there's also one in here that a lot of people don't know about. Also, once you beat Plague Knight, there's a Plague Coin you can buy from him. You also get an achievement for talking to the Pun Frog over and over and over until you've heard every single pun he has, which I think is quite fun. But yeah, I actually, I'm not gonna do it, because if I can successfully beat Treasure Knight stage without dying, without losing all my gold anyways, then I will actually be able to, spend all this fucking sweet gold on something else. I do like that you can activate co-op at any time. I'm trying to figure out if I want to do the Iron Whale first. I'm just gonna get it over with, because it fucking, it's my, like, the theme is great. I love the boss. I mean, he's a pain in the ass for me. I personally always struggle with him. But, I think he's a cool boss, like, he's well made and shit. I love the theme of his stage, like, this is the one water level that I don't think is bullshit. You know, platformer? Like, of course a little bit, and they're doing it a little bit to make fun of the fact that everyone fucking hates water levels. And I appreciate that. I appreciate the jokes. Also, you can do, if you aim it just right, yeah, you can kill him, and also get the secret fucking treasure that's up here, which is pretty neat. Also, it is strange, the only reason I'm playing is male Shovel Knight, because Lady Shovel Knight, her dialogue is not sassy, and I think it's pretty fun. The only reason I'm playing Dude Shovel Knight is I don't think it affects feats, but I'm not 100% sure. So just to be safe, I'm doing, like, vanilla stock as a Shovel Knight. Plus, like, it really doesn't fucking matter. Shovel Knight's a chick. Like, Shovel Knight's just a cool character in general. It doesn't matter what gender it is, right? Just a fucking neato character. Also, there have been so many times where I've died on those spikes because I did not, I didn't understand the concept of, jump heights in the water. So when I would go to jump out of the water into the little hole that leads down here, I would always jump too high. Same with right here. I would always jump way too high because I didn't realize that there are actually three jump levels, which is interesting for a platformer where I jump most of the time, but I did not realize that there were different types of jumps. Even just like, what the fuck? Okay, well, I'm literally right there. It's fine. Actually, just fucking see. I think it's funny, I'm sure most of you watched the Game Grumps play this, because let's face it, that was fucking hilarious. When they did it co-op, I thought it was funny. Aaron used the phase locket to get across that. And it was actually Dan who figured out that you can literally just ride the snails to victory. Which is funny because, like, I guess in canon for Game Grumps, like, Aaron has beaten that game, like, probably 20 or 30 times. He is a man who enjoys his video games. And, like, I get that. I'm the same way. I fucking love video games. They're great. But, that being said, it was just funny to me that Aaron, I don't know if he didn't realize it or he just decided not to do it, but I don't think he realized that was a thing to do. Well, fucking shit. Okay. That's fine. That's my bad for hitting that stupid. Like, I knew that was gonna happen. Let's be real, we all knew it was gonna happen. Me breaking all the platforms and being like, no, it's gonna be fucking fine. Oh yeah, there's actually no reason to do that now. But yeah, there are plenty of ways to just kind of easily do this. You know, like not sucking a dick and just going. What the hell? My bad. But yeah, another reason I get a lot of help, in case you're wondering, in case you're thinking, oh, well, it's because you suck. That is part of it. I'm bad at games. And I just... I just want to beat the game and get the achievement for it. Like, the fight with the Enchantress is fucking awesome, and I love clearing out the Hall of Heroes with the ghosts, the little mini-boss for that. I think it's super well done and really creative. Honestly, I fucking adore this game. It's... No. Okay. Most of the time, I don't have to bounce the site off that other... I know this is something that bothered me a lot when I first started this level specifically. One of the things that killed me a lot is I did not understand how that was meant to work. A little segment with the eels. Like, I knew in my head, like, you know, what the goal was, but I didn't actually... Hey, Adam. I didn't know how to actually successfully do it. And this is something that I do for speedrunning this level. It's funny, as long as you actually just watch the chest, don't even think about Shovel Knight, just assume that he's doing the right thing. Unless that happens, but see, oh fuck. But see, you can still generally correct it if something funny happens. Who the fuck is messaging me on Twitter? Stop. I don't know why I literally always have trouble with this guy. He's not hard. I know he's not difficult. Like, his pattern is easy, and I know how to do it. I just always do it wrong. I always take... Oh my god. Fucking... I have everyone and their brother messaging me right now. I'm sorry that my phone is just exploding in the corner. It is cool, though, because, like, he gives you a chest. Oh my god. Fucking... Stop. I'm gonna have to mute my fucking phone. It's actually gonna be straight up. Gonna mute my phone. And clear all my notifications and just... But yeah, by the anchor, of course. I know last time I got here, I had like exactly 3,000 gold. I suck at this game. I love it, and I think I'm actually... It's one of the few games I actually genuinely would tell you. I think I'm good at this game. I don't like to say that often, because obviously, like, you know, I don't want to be a dick and be like, oh, I'm good at this game. I've always thought, unless you're, like, seriously fucking stellar at a game, then you have no right to say you're good at a game. Like, I don't know, you can say you're good at it, but, like, you know, a lot of people are like, oh my god, I'm so fucking good at this game. It always bothers me. I know Doom 2016 was one game that I will genuinely fight you. I used to be fucking awesome at that game. And Shovel Knight was one of those other games that I thought I was actually good at. Actually thought I was a decent player. And, like, I haven't played it in a while. Now that I'm in the speedrun competition, though, I am actually, you know, I'm playing it again, and I'm improving again. But, no, there was a period of time where I was much better than I am now, and I miss it, honestly, being decent at this game. Honestly, you can just glitch yourself out of your fucking head. That's the best way I found to kill him. Did lose a little bit of gold there, but it's not a big deal. I don't know why I'm saying every single thing I'm doing. You guys can see that I lost a little bit of gold there and shit. Like, what do I need to tell you? You guys can see it. I guess I'm just kind of in, oh my god, people are watching mode. And so I'm talking like way too much and being an annoying old man. Happens though, I suppose. Like, I suppose there are certain... Oh, fucking shit. Fuck you. A lot of times you can kill him with that anchor, and it's absolutely like that. Essentially, you do that. But with the first anchor, so that when you're... Ooh, so when you're doing this part, there's actually nothing to stress about. I actually hate the anchor throwing guys, because they're like, they block you if you jump on them, or they hit you if you jump on them, and then they beat the fuck out of you from, like, in front of you, generally, you know? That's why there's chicken here, though, because even the developers realize that literally just those guys alone pose a known threat, it's annoying. I'm feeling good about this run, though, like, regardless of the fact that I'm getting my ass kicked by Anchorman again. Not even Ron Burgundy. So, like, I'm disappointed in the Anchorman that's kicking my ass. It was Ron Burgundy. Like, hell yeah, dude. I do love, though, that you can kill, like, almost everyone in this room with one single shell hit. It only works if you do it right there, though. So it is actually kind of a timing game. Also, you do, fun little fact, though, because you generally get a little bit of knockback when you hit those, it is best to... it's best to fucking... What am I trying to say? Stand on the front edge of that platform. I actually used the phase blocker for this fight because this guy, there's so many times where like he does this animation and sometimes he flies up, other times he doesn't. And it's like I just don't know how to read him a lot of the time. And he's also kind of kicks the shit out of me constantly. Which is also why I'm going to actually ready one of my chalices so that when he inevitably beats the fucking shit out of me. This. No, okay, I hit the wrong... I've been playing a lot of another game that has Dead Cells. I mean, Adam, you've seen it. I'm playing a lot of Dead Cells, which the use button is right bumper, which in this game is switch item. So, like, I just got my buttons confused. There's a way to dodge that, and it's being on, you know, the left side of his character model, putting on the right, which is fucking gunny. I don't know why I literally always fuck that up. Every time without fail, I fuck that up. No, if that hits you, you're almost guaranteed to go in that chest. Which means, he steals a fuck ton of your gold. Just cause he's a dick. That's what he does. He doesn't really try to kill you, he just wants to steal your money. He is also the most lucrative boss in the game, though. I guess not the most. It depends on... If you kill him first try, you get, like, 6 grand. If you die, then you only get 25. Which is still a lot. Like, boy, I have 17 grand. I'm gonna go buy all the armor. Not all the armor. I don't think I can afford all the armor. I'm definitely getting all the shovel upgrades. And I'm getting the purple armor. I'm probably going to buy multiple sets, but the one that I'm actually going to use is the purple set. And this man appears with his fucking boomerang. I hate him. I generally come back to him later because he's a bit of an asshole. Also, cool thing you can do while I have all this money, before I go buy shit. Is if you actually pay these people, it's 3 grand. Then this man will fight you. And if you win, you get 5. His name is Hat Man. He doesn't believe that your hat is a helmet. So he wants to fucking beat the shit out of you for your quote-unquote helmet. And it's funny. His dialogue's actually very well done. All the dialogue in this game is very well done. I hate this phase. Honestly, this phase is like my least favorite of his. Because he just keeps fucking bouncing. And like, see, it's very doable. But it's also very frustrating. But yeah, he's generally easy enough to fight. So I'm going to go ahead and buy a couple bits of armor. There's also the, there's that music note up there. Which I can show you how to get if you're curious. Oops, I don't want to do armor man first. I want to do upgrade boy. Get all those upgrades. Because they're all really good. The drop spark's really fucking expensive, but it's great, it's very useful. It's kind of like Mega Man, or not Mega Man, who am I thinking of? What fucking game is that? I can't remember. Okay, so we get to pick one. I will pick, the Finder's Coat, because it's fucking great. Okay, wait, I need to go get that music sheet. Because if I can get another grand, I will come back here and get the, I'll come back here and get the fucking other, the red suit, because it cuts in half the amount of gold you lose when you die. Okay, so we do have to fight this boy. If we want to do that, because we haven't beat Plague Knight. Actually, I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to go fight Mole Knight first. Because I like having a lot more equipment before I fight, fuck, what am I doing? Well, there's a secret over here that I can't reach now. I guess I'll just leave the fucking stage. Leave the stage and come back. Sometimes that also moves the guys. You know what, I'm just gonna fight him. That'll be fine. He's a loser, and like, nothing I can't solve with a little bit of, firepower. I do hate though that I use his armor for him, because I always take a lot of damage with him every time, and now having half health is a bit of an issue. Like, I understand how his pattern works, I'm just bad at it, if that makes sense. I see, normally I would still have another hit, so I wouldn't be concerned. But now I actually have to be concerned. Because it's a conjurer's build, but as you can see, I have enough mana to generally use whatever items I want with this thing on. So I can just kind of blast the fuck out of them when I want. It's really nice. So like, it's doable with the Conjurer's Coat. It's just infinitely more difficult than it would be otherwise. Also, he drops money in a music sheet, which is always nice, which means going back to sell the music sheets is more lucrative. Like, I love the Conjurer's Coat, but that's why I generally get so much health. So they have made, what, 1,500 off of that exchange? Don't have 6 grand to buy another. Do I have a... I don't think I have a, yeah, I don't have a Goatigen thing. A Goatigen Skull. I'll get one once I beat the other two bosses. I'm not gonna do the next boss runs with this coat. The Conjurer's Coat, I mean. Like, that's generally what I wear when I do, when I did my speedrun attempts. But, because I'm probably going to die because I'm going for secrets and shit, I'm actually gonna go ahead and wear the red one. I've changed my mind. The purple one is my favorite overall. I think it's, fuck, I think it's my favorite. Like, because having that much magic is fucking great. But, real talk, I don't use it that much. And, you know, there's other ways to get a shit ton of money. So it's like, why really fucking worry about it too much, I guess. No, shit. Gonna save the time of that, you can actually get the... No! Okay. Fine, it's fucking... Okay. Well, this is fine. It's not the most... Oh my god. It's not the most lucrative treasure run. In fact, it's very not lucrative. I did fucking horrible on that. I could have made like $3,000, but I made... What is that? A little over two? I'm gonna go ahead and buy the red armor. And then we're out of here. Actually, I don't think I'm gonna. Because all it does is let you drop half gold. I'm just gonna wear default armor. And I'm gonna go buy the other Goatigen thing so I have my full health. I feel like it would be putting me at a disadvantage to use the Conjurer's Coat right now. And I'm not in like, oh yeah, we should just fucking speedrun this mode. Because that's the only time I use items that much. So if I'm gonna be trying to do, not really completionist, but I guess try and be at least thorough. And, you know, I'm doing it for a stream and stuff. Might as well take standard damage. go ahead and do Mole Knight stage first. I don't generally try to go down and get, like, you can break all of those platforms and they all have big old gems in them and stuff, as one would expect. I generally don't go for that, just me. No, fuck. Because of exactly that. That's why I don't go for it. I don't know why I went down. Anyways, I earned more gold than I lost, so I'm gonna go ahead and count that and move on. I still earned money from that, so... But yeah, mainly the main upgrade that I'm a fan of, not so much the drop spark or anything like that, but the one-hit treasure digging is fucking awesome. It's really fucking helpful. Is it very good? I don't know why I did that. Honestly, I knew that was coming. He's like, oh fam, it'll be good. But yeah, you know, mistakes were made. It'll be fine. If you guys want, I can use the Conjurer's Coat, like, later. Oops, what am I doing? I took way more damage from him than I should have. But ew. Let's wait for them to do this cycle. There's no reason to hit them twice, I just like to. Fuck it. I also like waiting for them to at least be here. Almost just like a safety net sort of deal. Just so I know I have that as an option. Also, sometimes you can get all of them to actually fall into that lava. I remember the first time I did this, that was horrifying. But it is super cool. I love that as like a thing. It's just like, yeah, just keep fucking going and these things will... They will appear where they need to. What? No! What? He didn't put his shovel down. Okay. It's probably my bad. It's okay, we can get it back. And it ought to be the whole thing again. Just most of it. I don't know if there's actually possible to get all of it. No! Okay, well, fuck it. That's one thing that this game has taught me, is like, if you lose your gold in one spot too many times, especially in a position like this, I've already bought most of it. I bought almost everything I want. And the only thing I could want, really, is another set of armor. That's purely cognitive. It doesn't actually affect fucking anything. Yeah, that's one thing that I've learned is like, if you're in a position like this, where you didn't have a lot of gold to begin with, and you lose some, just go. I think it's funny when people get themselves killed multiple times. Same as in Dark Souls, honestly. It's like, why is it such a big deal? Gotta get the Dust Knuckles. It's the best. Okay. No. That's fine. That's probably what I should have saved my money on. I can always come back and redo this level just for the Dust Knuckles. Honestly, it's useful for one event. And I'll have that much gold if I just wait 2 seconds and, you know, come back at the end of the stage, maybe. Like, fight the boss, redo the stage, just come back purely for that gold. Or for that item. Because there is a gold stage that you actually can't do without the Dust Knuckles, so it's actually very important. If you're like me and you want to get all the things. Whoa. That's always stressful. Like, I know how it plays out. But it's always slightly stressful for me. But yeah, as you can see, I'll be able to go back and get the Dust Knuckles fairly shortly. It won't be a big deal. I mean, it'll be a bit of a big deal, but not like crazy. Luckily there was no like chicken or anything under there. It's not a big deal. I'm actually going to break this checkpoint. One, because it's a shit ton of money. And two, because if I die right here, which I can easily get back to, then I am infinitely closer to the Dust Knuckles. I can go get them. Oh shit. Well, that's the one problem with that plan, isn't it? Is that gonna get me 300 gold? Yes, it is. Okay. We're good. But yeah, I love the Dust Knuckles. I have to get them. It's like my favorite item in the fucking game. I kinda had to get them. Plus, like, I've beaten the stage fucking hundreds of times. I'm positive I can get back there without dying, so I'm going to. And see, I still have, like, half the amount of money I had when I got here, so it's fine. Just don't fucking die, and we'll be good. Watch, now I'm gonna die. Also, I lost a couple hundred gold. Like, overall, like, I net a couple hundred. It's fine, though. Because, again, I've beaten this game a bunch, so... shouldn't be a big deal. I always kind of hated that it was like the last possible bounce to get up on there, but I guess that's what makes it kind of stressful. So it makes perfect sense why they did it like that, but it's also very stressful to execute. Oh, you had to fight him again? I didn't realize you had to fight him a second time. No. Okay, sweet. So I didn't lose my gold. Oh, I broke a checkpoint. I wasn't losing gold. I love how they put those guys there, like, just to try and get you to fuck up. It's like, you guys are evil. I fucking hate you. Okay, well, that's fine. We still have the checkpoint at the end. Also, there is actually a secret. In case that wasn't incredibly obvious. But this box didn't respawn, so it's just a chicken up there. I'm gonna die. I've just owning up to it. I'm going to die. Oh wait, I have tropical challenges, I'm not gonna die. Fuck this. Look at this whole dying business. Okay. If you get tropical chalice, I'm gonna go ahead and use one. Also, I'm gonna use the dust knuckles. For this part, because he does throw a lot of dirt at you. That's probably why they put it in his stage. But yeah, it's quite a lucrative boss fight. Most of them are. It's easy enough if you have a decent amount of health, which is part of why I always go for health. And like, if I had full health, you can see I would have beaten him easy. So I did. Essentially. And now that I have that, okay, he's trying to block me a little bit, that's fine. But we can actually go to Knuckles Quarry now that we actually have the Dust Knuckles. Which, if I can do without dying, for some reason there's always a spot where I kind of get hung up. If I can actually do it without dying, and then, you actually, you know, treasure level, so it's exactly what you expect from a treasure level. You get a decent amount of treasure from it. But see, that happens a lot, where I'm just oh so slightly off, and then it fucks up everything. So, yeah, it is what it is, I suppose. What am I gonna really do about it? Just get better at this game. Which is what I'm actively trying to do, so. But, like, I'm hitting the button. It's just not doing it. Probably because I suck at this game, but that's whatever. I know if you do this with the, I should have done this with the purple armor on. What the fuck? Okay. But see, I was hitting the button. You saw the fist. Okay, I'm just not gonna do it. Because see, you don't actually lose money if you just quit the stage. It just counts it as a loss because you didn't even try to finish it. So it's like, I still have 6 grand, so I still think I'm doing well. Oh fucking shit, I didn't mean to. To return to the map and fill up my tropical chalice real fast. Okay, so now that that's filled up, we can go ahead and continue on with our day. I mean, I still had one extra, but Plague Knight is the stage where I accidentally used one early like an idiot, so I want to make sure that now that I'm packing two, I want to make sure I use the gold. I might actually go buy the red armor, because it's fun to be not stock Shovel Knight at the end of the game, I think. Maybe I'll save up for the gold, I don't know. I'll finish that treasure stage eventually and actually get the gold armor, because I'll actually have money for it. I hate these rats. Like, it's... I always struggle dealing with them without dying. Like, just because they explode, like, after you hit them. Because, like, you have to hit them and run away. I do love the Explodatorium theme, though. Like, not only the song, but just the style of the level. I think it's really cool. Like, it's got a lot of really bright neon colors and shit. I think it's really cool. But I am a fan of neon. And this part's actually, I guess, relatively difficult. Oh my god. Relatively difficult to time, because if that rat isn't up here, which he's not, so I have to reload the area before I kill him. There's not a way to get back here. Fuck. Okay, well there's music up there, and if you can actually get that rat to stay the fuck up there, which obviously now he's stuck down here for all of eternity, you can actually get him to stay up there. There's music notes, which of course need free money. Money for me. It would have been nice, but I can redo the save later, but a completionist run, 100% for sure. Just because, you know, fuck it. It'll be cool. But yeah, the platforming stages with the barrels I think are pretty cool. The stage has a lot cool going for it. The background's fucking rad as shit. It does make you slow down a little bit though, so it kind of reminds me of, what is it? The zone from Sonic, Marble Zone? That makes you kind of slow the fuck down for 2 seconds. And like, that zone, not my favorite, gotta be real with you. But, no, in this, it was very well implemented. There was a secret up there, I knew there was. I don't know why I didn't get it. That was really fucking stupid. But yeah, I know it's not showing, because I'm playing fucking terribly, but I do play this game a lot. I didn't really think of the fact that I died in the same level, but believe me, I do actually play this game quite a lot. For a linear platformer, I play this game as much as a lot of people play open world survival games. And that might also be part of why it says I only have like 35 hours or something in this game, 38 hours. Because, there's actually a lot of it there. Again, I was offline or something. And so that would explain why it shows so little hours. Freaking, I played so much. This little mini boss is fun. I quite enjoy it. It's also a fun fact, he doesn't actually have a health bar. He has just a pattern, and you have to just see him through his whole pattern. Okay. Oh. Oops, fuck. Okay. I was gonna say, I don't know how many hits he has left. Sometimes he has a second phase with the Yeti form. Had I known it was literally right there, I wouldn't have used my my challenge. That's why I would have killed. Because this level always makes you fuck up like that. Something about this level, dude. I don't know. Oh, filled it up with a movie already. Nice. Okay, so it's not all a loss. I got invincibility, so I can actually take shit a shot. Also, I hate this green thing. Like, with my whole being. You can nudge him off the edge if you very gently. Just very fucking gently. emphasis on very gently. Yeah, you can knock his ass off the edge. And that's generally how I deal with him. He sucks. Also, there's always a carrot there. Your first time. Okay, this always used to give you trouble getting to this door. What the hell? Okay, there we go. See if I can actually beat this without dying. Like a loser. It's just a oh my god, I knew it was gonna do that, and I still went. Okay, it should be a lot. Fuck these guys. They're the worst. They're like, they're almost like booze, but worse. In my opinion, anyways. But yeah, we're almost at the end here. These green shovel knights mean you're almost at the end. The goo knights, I think this is what they're technically called. There's actually a book that explains all this that I'm actually going to get sometime soon. They're easiest to deal with when you have the, whatever the fuck this thing's called. The drop spark, I think is what it's called. Because they'll do this, and maybe... Well, I lost the drop spark, that's fine. Sometimes you can get them to fall into a pit. It's always funny. To me, at least. I always find that pretty funny. You do it, like, right on the edge. And they will literally just fall into a fucking pit and die. Something I'm sure we've all thought about an enemy in a game before. Just fall into a pit and die. But yeah, literally this guy is the last guy before the boss. And I was fighting him. And I was like, oh fuck, I'm gonna die. Because I had like have a bubble left. And guess what? Next screen, there is a turkey. So, or a chicken. Turkey? I don't know. I think it's a chicken. Because it would be like Castlevania. Like I wasted my chalice literally right there. It's just ridiculous of me. So I went into this fight, which, again, I love Plague Knight, but I don't like playing as him. It's a cool fight. I actually played this fight a bunch before I played the Plague Knight DLC, so I could understand his moveset a little better. But yeah, he's just, he does a lot of like, oh, well, I'm gonna be 200 miles away and a little baby bump and also leave fire on the ground, and also he can make those giant cauldrons that explode into things a little bit, and those multi-bombs which you don't get when you play him, which is more just frustrating than anything. Like, I saw this cool pal in the boss fight, and I wanted to, like, oh god, I have way more health than I thought. Last time I did this, I fucking died, like, 7 times. So I guess I came into this expecting to die a shit ton. Even though I'm not okay. The only reason I'm doing okay though is because I have some fucking health. That's another reason, is it means bosses that I'm incompetent and shit at, I can actually just power through like a boss. So I'm gonna go by the gold armor. Not because it helps at all, it literally just lets you do a flip when you jump, and you're gold. But that's way cooler than normal ass Shovel Knight, so... Well, I mean, normal Shovel Knight's great, to get me wrong. But as far as for a stream, we'll go ahead and do that. Also, we can tell we beat a zone, because there's the chest and we're doing this following game. Super concerned with actually earning money during this, to be quite honest with you. Like, it'd be great, but I'm not really hyper concerned with it. Gold and catcher. Technically, you don't actually have to. So in theory, you can just leave and whatever. But yeah, free meal ticket. Which means, obviously, I'm gonna use it, because it's free, so why the hell not? Also, redeeming this meal ticket means that, I don't have to fight those guys yet. I didn't get anything in the stage. There is music in that stage, I always miss that one. Oh, shit. And actually, because I have so much, I am gonna go ahead and get a little more magic. Make it a nice ditty. And we can leave. I'll go back to the armor outpost. I will also fill up my tropical chalice. With health. Because the invincibility is great and all, but health is way better, in my opinion. But yeah, we're gonna go get the sweet gold armor. The swiggity swiggity armor. Again, it's literally just cosmetic, but look at it. We are gonna do this stage real quick, because I wanna see if I can earn the other armor. I should. It literally costs. I need literally 40 gold. Also, one thing that's great about having so much health is I can be incompetent in the city at this game and still succeed. I love that he does flips though. Like, it's fucking rad. Oops, wanna get down. Like, I hate lightning levels for fiery fucking passion. But, oops, I'm gonna go get this guy. But at the same time, I love gold. Oops, he does that every time. I generally don't fight him because it's just precarious when he dies trying to land properly. He thinks he's blocked my route, but he hasn't. That guy's just a bit of a dick. I'll get him in a second. We all want to wear that gold. That gold armor is the best armor. I do wish it gave you some kind of a stat increase at all. I mean, I guess it makes sense that it's really just for show. Do I have to redo the Hall of Champions? I do. Okay. Hall of Champions takes fucking forever. Oh yeah, you need a fucking meal ticket. Or no, 5,000 gold. Still, it's expensive. But yeah, you get to fight a really cool boss if you do that. And then here is generally where I kind of stop. Most of the time when I play. It's like, all three of these knights kind of suck, in my opinion. Notice how I was like, that was the fucking boss. Whoa, 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 my dude. What the fuck is this? Last time he was already dead. I just got him trapped in the corner and fucking wrecked his ass. Apparently he came to play today. That's okay, if I'm concerned, I have chalices for that. That's one thing I like about having two. Like, I could fully heal twice. Just for fucking shits and giggles. Like, it won't be necessary, but if I needed it, it's there, and so... I'm also just bad at fighting bosses, I've found. So that's always... It's always fun. It's always a fun time. Always enjoy getting my ass kicked by bosses. But we're gonna go ahead and do Tinker Knight first. Just because, I don't know, I had to pick one of them. So Tinker Knight's my boy. I think my least favorite boss to fight is, Propeller Knight. Guy's an asshole. This fight actually is really fun. I really genuinely enjoy the fuck out of this fight. I always forget that those fuckers are humans. Because I always kind of assume that it's a one-hit deal. And then they're not. It's just like, fuck me, I guess. Technically, that, yeah, I'm gonna get it. I was gonna say there's a way around those. Like, you can just go under, you know, whatever. It's not a huge deal. It's the fishing pole. It's only six, so I might as well. Whoops. Well, rip secret. Again, I'm gonna come back for it later. But yeah, I'm shit at this stage, but it's a cool stage. As shit as I am at it, it's just good. It's a well-made stage. I'm just bad. That's really all this equates to. But yeah, me being bad is why I always go for a lot of health. That way I can persevere and get my ass for it. Because it's like, if I can get my ass through there anyway, so... No! That rat does that almost every time without fail. I hate it. Because, like, I can see it coming. I know it's gonna happen. And I'm trying to prevent it. I'm trying to be good. Prevent that shit. But every time. It's like, nah, fam. What if I still hit you, though? Every damn time. I don't know what else to do. I'm trying to, like, bounce on him. Which I think is what you're supposed to do. In the speedrun, that's what they do. It's fucking like 100% speedrun that I watch. I fucking bounce on his ass. Like, I gotta get that though. Cause like, there's a lot of treasure. I'm gonna try and just... What? There we go. God, these fucking things. Notice I'm complaining a lot. I'm not meaning to complain. You have to understand. It's slightly frustrating, though. This weird bullet feels. Technically, there is a secret over there if you ride on them. I'm not confident enough that I'm going to... Fucking... God, I... Was slightly off. Slightly off. It's fine. I don't have to deal with that fucking rat anymore. That was just a stupid mistake, so I can fix that. Outta here. Oh, the four hit? Whatever. God. It's like they know people want a speedrun. Or at least, you know, And they're just like, how about we place everything in, like, literally the least opportune place? And if you're wondering why I'm not going for that gold, like, I missed, it's like 200 gold, I think. And I'm gonna get that back in this room alone. I'm gonna make more than that. So, not really concerned. Plus, this is this map. Giving me one of the most broken items in the entire game. Like, it's really good. Saying it's really good is an understatement, actually. It's, again, it's one of the best items in the game. So yeah, you could say it's decent. Also, I know a lot of it. Whoa, no! Fuck! Hate it when that happens. Especially because literally the checkpoint is all the way back here. Have to do all of that again. It's like, yay, thanks guys. Stop with the... Okay. I do like that those rats fall over on their own. You're just like, oh shit. I would do that if I was a mechanical rat, like, honestly. Shit can't be easy. I like that it's always a chicken. Like, let me get my gold. No! Okay. Fine. I'm always bad at these last three stages. Every time I fuck up on something. I'm just fucking bad at these last three stages for some reason. It's just not meant to be for me. This is always the part where my attempted speed runs. What? Okay. That was my bad. I can't even be mad. It's just like I suck at this game. Whatever. In fact, what I can do is just return the map and come back, and then I have more money. Polar Night is my least favorite. I'm really not looking forward to that at all. But yeah, we're gonna just kind of speed through this. I don't really care. I just want to get to the boss. Like, you know, I'll get... some of the more obvious big boy trigger. But I'm not gonna break back over it. Like, it's not really worth it. I need to just calm down and focus is really what it boils down to. A lot of times when I die a lot in a game, as most people do, I get frustrated, and then I start fucking up more because I'm frustrated. And it's like, I could have just calmed the fuck down and done much better. I still hate these fucking things, though. So annoying! The thing that I hate about them is they're not hard, they're just... It's just hard to get a lock on them, I guess. most annoying type of difficulty to me. When it's enemy isn't hard, but hitting it is. Especially when you know, oh, well, it's not that fucking hard. Like, you know you should be kicking its ass, but you're just not, for one reason or another. Whoa. Okay. Dodging the bullet, boys. I don't really care about the mouse noise. Again, I'm just not going to try to do this. I just want to beat it and move on with my day. Like, this treasure is worth. No, okay. Please no. I hate these little bullets. Again, not even because they're hard. Just because they're kind of annoying. No! Literally next screen. It's a checkpoint. But yeah, see, this is what I mean by I always fuck up at these last three bosses. Every fucking time. And it's just annoying because, like, I know why I'm fucking up. It's the same places every time. And it's just frustrating. And it's not even like, oh, well, you can just, you know, I just need to improve on platforming. There we go. Oh. Whoops. Probably should have been on that. I just saw it go away and I'm just like, well. Fucking stop it. No! We still got a checkpoint. All that matters. Well, okay. Gonna leave them up there. Don't care. They can be... Oh, well, fuck. Okay, well, I mean, we're not doing great. We're not doing well, either. Doing really bad. But it's okay. I have two full heals, so we're gonna make it work. Whoa. Forgot about this part. Fuck. I mean, I know that, Propeller Knight stage does something like this. Propeller Knight, the whole stage is about being in the air. That is slightly more expected of him, I suppose. Come on. There we go. Thank you. secret boss arena, building yourself a set of stairs. See, the boss himself, I think, is a really fun fight. You'll see why in a minute if you haven't seen him already. Wait, and you're like, wow, I beat him really fucking easily. But wait, there's more. Yeah, he's the only boss that officially has to help us. And this is why I bring chalices. Also the face on this nice. Always. Also the third phase to this man. Third again, this part's pretty fucking easy. I mean, I'm not making it look easy, it's a sucking game. Like, trust me, it is. You actually know what you're doing. Okay, if you get to it. Wait. What did I do wrong? There's supposed to be a third phase. Maybe I killed him too fast. I don't know. There's supposed to be a phase where you have to balance on his machine while he screen chases you, essentially. Kinda reminds me of like a Sonic boss in the way that it's laid out, honestly. For fighting this man. Don't really get a choice. Here he comes. Yeah, this guy's a dick. Maybe he'll be easier as Shovel Knight, because the first time I actually fought him was Spectre Knight. And Spectre Knight is a completely different man. Plus a Garden Chalice. Oh yeah, he's infinitely easier to go. Hands down easier. Look at him. Look at this fucking loser. Yeah, as a... As Spectre Knight, that is a much harder fight. We'll also fight this man, just cause. I still have a chalice, correct? I do. Going to refuse him. Because believe it or not, he's actually kind of difficult. Boy. do his thing. You just have such an ass that they kill this enemy. Because it keeps saying, like, there's nothing hard in your brain. It's just sucking for me. Okay. And for the relic, there's a bit of distance. I think the most difficult of these little mini-bosses. But he's still not super hard, and he's worth a lot of money, so that's cool. So, huzzah, he wanted to be one of the Order of No Quarter. But he's not cool enough. Apparently I've just now beaten every single... Okay. I mean, I've beaten the game, but... Maybe reset all my achievements, I don't know. Because I did notice that I didn't have even the achievement for having killed like 6 enemies. So, maybe we'll purchase all of the armor? Just cuz. Just cuz I can. The gold is the best though, let's be real. Alright, so we will go ahead and do the flying machine next, because this is my favorite theme song in the entire game. I fucking love this song, it's so good. I've listened to just this singular song on a loop before for like a day, because it's awesome. It's like, come on, Shovel Knight, Jesus, Shovel Knight, come on. Okay, you know what, try to get it. How the fuck? How? That's the only way to get up there. Well, and the platform you're supposed to land on is also gone. I don't get it. That's the only way up there. What am I doing wrong? You know what, whatever. I was dropped down from above and couldn't do it. Because I want that treasure. There we go. I swore you could get to it from that fan. I would have sworn in my life you could get to it from that fan. Apparently we're just going to be at this one stage of it forever. So, wait, I didn't fill up the travel chalice, did I? No, I did not. I should fix that. Because this is... probably my least favorite boss in the game to fight. So we will fill up my I-Core. And then we'll continue. Boop, boop. Fucking do it. Good mood, I'm ready for this. Fucking do it. What the fuck? Okay, my good mood is fading. That was bullshit. There we go. At least this team's not good. Like, I'm fucking this up really bad. Because I just kind of want to get through this stage. God, how much I hate the little propeller move. It's a lot. In case you were wondering, I hate them a lot. Like, the design's cool, but I don't like actually fighting them. Oops, this is where it was. I should go get that mound first. Wow, I'm bad at this game. Stop! With your fucking turbine ass. Fucking god, I hate those things. They are actually my least favorite. They're kind of annoying. I've definitely dealt with the worst enemies in games. It's just annoying because they're almost more of an environmental obstacle than anything else. Whoa! Fucking shit, I knew as soon as I jumped. Sorry. I need to step up my fucking game. I do think all of these are, like, fucking the way walls are. It's an interesting concept, but they're annoying. What? Okay. I guess smashing the jump button doesn't make you jump. I'm at that point where I'm so frustrated with just, you know, wanting to be done with this stage of the game, because I hate all three of these bosses, and, like, I love the soundtrack, like the theme song for them. I don't like fighting. Like, I love this game, but there are also parts of it that I fucking hate sometimes. Like, I just kind of whoa. Okay. I just want to beat it, you know? I'm at that point where it's like, I've played this game this much. Just fucking go. Just go! Like, I despise this stage. Not even because it's poorly designed, just because I'm bad at it. It's the fucking windmill boys. Whoa. It's annoying because I know as soon as I beat them, they drop a fucking thing. I probably could have just done this. No, I would have been dead. Yeah, I would have fucking died. Okay, they dropped an apple. That's fun. Like, this stage is like incredibly well at disarming, but I hate it. That makes any sense. There is a secret down here. Stop with the propeller! Stop with the propeller! For the love of God! No! Okay, well, I'm never getting that back. Okay, just gotta calm the fuck down. That's all this is for me, is just a test of patience. Because I hate all three of these levels. And I have to play all of them back to back to back. I have to at least get the gold on. No. Out of here with that shit. Out of here with that shit. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hitting the butt, okay. Again, just gotta pull the fuck down and do- letting myself get frustrated by the fact that I don't like these levels and I need to just calm the fuck down and play. Fucking, oh my god. Oh my god. Plus I hate these bosses. Like, I don't know. This is becoming an intentional game. Even though I adore this game, I hate this section of it. Like, a lot. Well, I'm gonna end it there, because obviously I'm not in a good space of mind to do this right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop it here. We can do the last, it'll be I think 4 bosses, if you count the final boss and then the sub-final boss. We'll do that probably tomorrow. Thanks for watching, I will see you guys later.